artist friends. Today we are going to make some shape houses made from some simple shapes like triangles, squares, rectangles, till we have our whole little village living on our paper. So let's start today by using, if you want to use a pencil first and then erase if you make any mistakes and need to edit, and I'll be using a Sharpie to begin so you can see my drawing from far away. So the first thing we're going to do is make just a few squares and rectangles on our paper. I would say maybe, I don't know, 3 squares, 4 or 5 rectangles, just kind of pick where you'd like them to be. So I'm gonna do a little baby square over here, big long rectangle over here. Not too many because we need to fill it in. Maybe some tall the other way, but we're gonna try making some houses to be part of our village on our paper. And then one over here. Okay, so I've got some houses and some different little buildings that I'm going to turn into something a little more detailed. So for your squares, all you really need to do to the top, if we're getting kind of more of a traditional type house, the first way we learn how to draw a house with our square, and then we can make a pointed little triangle at the top, okay? So if you see some little squares like that, you can add your little triangles to the top this way. Boop. There we go. Now, if you have a rectangle, you can of course do a huge rectangle on your paper too, or you can make a triangle that doesn't go all the way across. Watch, my triangle that comes down this way is starting to look like a house that's long. So how I can finish it now is take this same angle of my triangle here and make that diagonal line coming from this point, boop, like that. Then I just need to connect this with a line, and all of a sudden I've got a house that has a little bit more beef to it, right? It's just a little bit bigger. So I'm gonna try this one. Looks like it needs a triangle. Here's another triangle, but let's do that trick that I did here over on this one. Triangle first, draw that same diagonal line, and then a straight one along the top. Cool. Now I can make some of my other buildings a little bit three-dimensional, sort of like this, if I want to. Watch. I'm going to make my lines come off of this edge from each little point. So I'm going to start at the very top of this one, come straight across, come straight across, come straight across, and then I just need to finish my lines on the other side. So again, same angle, and then come back down. Kind of looks like a big tall milk carton. But I'd live in that house. And I can try it again too. So I'm just making my lines a little bit bigger. I'm showing you different ways that you can turn your houses into something a little bit more three-dimensional. So let's say I'm gonna come to this itty bitty baby one. I'm gonna go across, across from the point, across from the point, all with an even sized line, and then come back down at that angle and come back down straight. Cool. I think maybe, I think I might just do my last one over here. Again, straight line across, straight line across, straight line across. Now there's lots of ways that you can make houses, and technically these houses don't really look like they're going back into space because we're just practicing. If they were, we'd have some more angled or diagonal edges, but we're just practicing today, so we're gonna keep it nice and straight. Now is the time where you get to add your final details. So of course, our houses need doors. And our doors can be rectangular. Maybe some of them are arched doors. Maybe some are double doors where they have a line in the middle. So you get to pick as the artist what you want your doors to look like. Check it out. Oh, super long, tall one, because this is a big building. There we go. Now we also need to add, oops, this one needs a little door. We also need to add some windows. And our windows, again, can be nice and long using those rectangles. They could be a few squares next to each other. But realistically, today, we're mostly just using triangles, rectangles, and this right here is called a parallelogram, meaning that it goes 2 directions diagonal and 2 directions parallel. So I'm gonna finish adding some windows. This one's got 3 circular windows in a row. This one I think I'm going to do 2 stacked rectangles and a circle above. What else needs windows? This little one needs a square. This one needs a circle above the door. And I think we're good. The final step is to now ground your houses so that they're not floating in space. So again, we need that little horizon line where the sky and the earth meet. Now, since my houses are way up here, my horizon line needs to at least be this high, because if I make a horizon line here, all of these are still floating in the sky. So I'm gonna make my horizon line here with a gentle curve. Remember, when you hit one of the objects, you're gonna pretend your line continues. and then come back up. I'm giving it a nice bubbly mountain top, and then stop. Now you can make some paths, some valleys, maybe even do some more lines where your mountains or your hills are separating, but I'm going to make mine, and I'm just going to do a gentle little curve, come back down with a hill. Should I do another one? Probably. I'll come up this way and curve back down. So now I've got some more interest when I color this in. You as an artist can of course add more details, right? So this is just the main shapes to start with. Maybe some of your houses have chimneys. Maybe some of your houses have little bushes next to them. Maybe some of your houses have pathways and people are taking a little walk, right? A little pathway that goes for a little walk off the edge of my page. So as the artist, you get to decide, my friends, what you're going to do to make your little cityscape or your little village come to life. Now, as always, the last step you're going to do is to color. And you can use any coloring tools that you have next to you to finish your work. So I'm just gonna finish, and I like these little shrubs. And then I'm gonna color. I feel good about the way that my houses look so cozy and calm and inviting with the simple shapes that I've drawn. Time to color. I loved coloring each of the different shapes that I created a little bit different from each other, so they're all brightly colored fun houses. I would certainly want to live in one of those. I also problem solved because my big spaces in the background felt really big, like they would take a long time to color. So to save on time, I just created a pattern to fill the space and it went way faster. My friends, I hope you had fun coloring and creating your houses today for your little village. Remember, you are strong, you are amazing, you are resilient, and I love you. We'll see you next time, friends.